Hello learners, I welcome you to EPG Pathshala. My name is Chef Jaswinder Singh and I'm working as Assistant Professor in University Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management. Dear scholars, I would be taking module named as Tandoor Cooking under the paper Food Production and Operations and Management. The primary objectives of the module would be to understand the history of tandoor, basic criteria to make tandoor, and different types of tenderizer used in tandoor cooking, different marinations, and recipes that are being prepared these days. The term tandoor refers to as a variety of ovens. It is most commonly known by its structure, which is cylindrical clay or metal oven used in cooking and baking. The tandoor is used for cooking of southern, central and western Asia, covering the whole Arab region to the Indian subcontinent, as well as in Caucasus. Charcoal and wood fire are used to generate heat in tandoor, burning within the tandoor itself, thus exposing the food to live, radiant heat cooking and hot air. Convection cooking and smoking by the fat and food juices that drips on the charcoal. Temperature in a tandoor can approach 480 degrees centigrade, that is 900 degree Fahrenheit, and it is common for tandoor ovens to remain lit for a long period to maintain the high cooking temperature. The tandoor design is something of a transitional form between a makeshift earth oven and the horizontal plan masonry oven. The tandoor word itself has a great long history and diversity, as it is spoken differently in different parts of the world, wherever it is in use. Like the tandoor is used in various languages, like dari, words tender and tanner. These are derived from similar languages, Persian and Armenian. Arabic tanner, Turkish tandir, Uzbek tandir, Azerbaijani tandir, and Kurdish tandoor. However, according to Decoder Persian Dictionary, the word originates from Akkadian tandoor. Tin means oud and niro, nura means fire, and is mentioned as early as in Akkadian Epic of Gilgamesh. In Sanskrit, the tandoor was referred to as kandu. Tandoor is also have a derived from Persian word tanur, derived from Babylonian word tinuru, based on Semitic word nar, fire. Types of tandoor: Afghan tandoor, the rational sits above the ground and is made from bricks. Punjabi tandoor, the Punjabi tandoor comes from the both India and Pakistan, is traditionally made from clay and is a bell shaped oven which is either be set into the ground and fired with wood or charcoal, usually reaching the temperature approximate 480 degrees centigrade or rest above the ground. Though India and Pakistan was separated in 1947, but the legacy of tandoor is still ongoing. After the partition of 1947, the Punjabi Hindus resettled in Delhi. In rural Punjab, many villages or local towns have their own communal tandoor so that people can come in unity, and that is also known as Sanja Chula. Armenian tonir. In ancient times, the tonir is worshipped by Armenian as a symbol of sun in the ground. In the Armenian capital city, Yerevan, many of the people still use tandoor oven so that they can produce and sell traditional Armenian bread. The underground tonir made of clay is one of the first tools in Armenian cuisine as an oven and as a thermal treatment tool. Equipments used in tandoor are seekh. It is made from wrought iron. They absorb and transfer heat, which helps in cooking the meat from both in and outer portion. The seekh should always be greased and rubbed with clean cloth before inserting food stuff on them. Hooks. For stuffed chicken and leaf wrapped dishes, there is another type of equipment called hooks, We can link two or three hooks together so that we can suspend them in the tandoor. Stitching and tying, a stuffed recipe has to be stitched up before it is inserted in tandoor. A trussing needle and thread of strong fiber is used in this. Skewering. It is important to skewer the meat in correct manner. Whole chicken need to be skewered carefully. The skewer not be inserted from neck end. Now we talk about making of a clay oven, tandoor. Stage 1. Once the clay is ready for use, slabs around 8 inch wide and around 40 inch long and at least 3 inch thick are made. Some dry clay is sieved and dusted over the rolled clay and shaped like cylinder. Two or three such rolled clay cylinders are kept ready to create base shape of the tandoor. Stage 2. The uppermost part of the tandoor is pinched after the base is made and then it is left to dry overnight so that it can hold the weight of the other hollow ring topped on. Stage 3. After drying, another sheet is topped on and the joints are notched. Together, this is all done after the verification of the correct hardness. This helps tandoor in the stability and firmness. Stage 4. Next, the shaping is done. As thick strip is added to create the mouth of tandoor, this makes the tandoor ready. The thickness is kept so that iron rods do not damage the delicate mouth openings. While working, as the iron rods slides on the mouth and may scrub the clay off. These days, thick iron rings are mounted as mouth opening. Later it is dried off and sometimes inserted in the iron drums and skewered with movable ball bearings, and handles are mounted on side for easy carrying. The clay for tandoor. The basic requirement for the construction for tandoor is clay, which must be free of any sandy contents. A non-pliable substance like mum, a kind of grass, is mixed with clay to give the natural strength to the clay with natural binders. Highly elastic clay is avoided in this as it forms crack quickly. Water is added and left overnight covered to make smooth mud base. Next day, it is beaten with hands or flat thick pads to give a smooth workable clay. Sometimes to strengthen the clay base, glass fibers and husk is added and best and heat retention while using it. Curing and preparing tandoor for ready to use. Every newly purchased tandoor needs curing. To do so, curing paste is applied. Curing paste. The curing paste includes boiled spinach paste, jaggery, salt and lots of mustard oil. These all ingredients are mixed together and cooked until it turns into a paste. It is then cooled and applied on the internal wall of tandoor. This is left for at least 3 days on the wall. And then tandoor is slowly heated using cow dung cake. Once more the paste is applied and tandoor is heated, filled with at least 1/3 level of coal at highest temperature. This is used to cure and strengthen the internal walls of tandoor. A wet cloth dipped in salt water is rolled on hot walls to clean the ash or any coal particles stuck on surface. For maintaining the heat, tandoor oven is extremely hot to work to because its temperature reaches 350 to 420 degrees centigrade. Tandoor has two openings. One is at the top, which is known as mouth opening, and the bottom, which is known as ventilation duct. There is not always one tandoor in hotel. There may be at least two for roti, naan, other for snacks. In early evening time, the coal are put lit, the bottom end to both openings mouths are opened, so that oxygen and fresh air can either help the coal to burn. Within 60 minutes, coal is burned to form amber and the both openings are closed. Sometime, the mouth is kept open a bit so that coal doesn't stop burning. If at all this happens, Lower ventilation duct is opened to heat up to tandoor again. Tools used on tandoori cooking. First one is gaddi, second is chopping board, third is roti jodi, fourth water container, fifth seek, sixth ceiling mounted iron rod to hook seek, snake rack, fat smearing brush, salted and salted water bowl, that is known as fatta, and poncha. Now we discuss about the role of marination. Marination is very required in any kind of meat cooking. It helps to tenderize the hard meat, tissues, bundle of various meats. It also helps to provide the seasoning to penetrate within muscles and develop the flavor. Meat becomes tender and it cooks fast. Different spices, marinades are used in tandoori cooking. Recipes for few are like red tandoori marinade, cooking red chili paste, yellow marination, malai marination, hariyali marination, achari marination. Different preparation that is being done in tandoori roti, breads, misi roti, lachha paratha, naan, khamiri roti, afghani roti, tandoori kulcha, shirmal, keema and paneer naan. Snacks. Seekh kebab, veggies, paneer, mutton, chicken, beef that is being cooked. Tandoori parcha kebab, tandoori gobi, tandoori tikka, tandoori chicken, tandoori paneer tikka, rane musallam, sikandari ran, pudina champ, pudina alu, bharma alu, ajwaini machhi tikka, fish mahi tikka, bukni kebab, tandoori jhinga, or pomfrey. These are some of the examples of tandoori dishes. There are various ingredients used in tandoori cooking. First one is ghee. Ghee is the finest structure of butter with originally zero milk residue. In this form, it is solid and will be stored for longer time. Dahi, yogurt or curd. Yogurt is fresh milk immunized with help of bacteria known as lactobacillus. It is the lactic acid in yogurt that converts meat fibers and retain the meat soft and tender when it is prepared in tandoor. Hung curd, there's another type of curd which is prepared by tying the curd in muslin cloth and hang it up, put a container under that because water will drain out from the cloth. Lime or lemon. Lemon is available in two varieties in India, namely green and yellow. It is also used in the marination of meats for kebabs. The citric acid content in this fruit is what causes the tenderizing action on meat fibers. Salt, it is used in very marination for taste and to give a crusty texture to body. Pepper, this is required for smoky flavor and to burn the inner content of body. Basting. It is the method of oiling the tikkas when they are 70% cooked. It is required to prevent overcooking and dryness to avoid dryness of tikkas. Now we talk about the tenderizing agents. Raw papaya. The papaya is an oval shaped fruit. It has a protein digesting enzyme known as pepin that gives it tenderizing property. Kachri, cucumis, pubescens. Kachri is wild variety of cucumis family. It is used as a tenderizing agent for meats in kebabs and biryani. Vinegar, it is made with yeast and juice of fruit. Acetic acid is a substance which gives its tenderizing quality. Khatti lassi, this is curd left to ferment and is more acidic than fresh yogurt. Raw pineapple, Ananas sativa. The active bacteria found in pineapple is bromelain, which has an action on raw papaya. Tamarind, Tramindus indica. It has two types of acids, one is citric acid and tartaric acid, that provides its recognized bitter taste. Brown mustard, Brassica gentia. It has very strong flavor and should be used in minute quantity because it has a sour taste. There are different types of marination that is used in tandoor cooking. Red marination, and the ingredients are Kashmiri red chili, 2 spoon ginger paste, 1 teaspoon garlic paste, 2 teaspoon garam masala, 1 teaspoon lemon juice, 1 teaspoon hunkar, 2 teaspoon salt to taste, mustard oil 20 ml. Method: first of all, make rogan using mustard oil and Kashmiri red chili powder. Now mix it with hunkard, then add ginger garlic paste to it and also lemon juice to it. Mix all ingredients well, add garam masala and salt to it. Now we talk about yellow marination. We need turmeric powder 2 teaspoon, ginger paste 2 teaspoon, garlic paste 1 teaspoon, lemon juice 1 teaspoon, hunkard 2 teaspoon, salt to taste, mustard oil 20 ml. Method is, make a rogan out of mustard oil and turmeric powder. Add ginger garlic paste to it and also lemon juice to it. Mix all ingredients well, add garam masala and salt to it. Now we talk about green marination, haryali marination. Ingredients: we need spinach 15 grams, coriander 10 grams, salt to taste, garlic paste 1 teaspoon, ginger paste 2 teaspoon, chaat masala 1 teaspoon, lemon juice 1 teaspoon, hunkar 2 teaspoon, mustard oil 15 ml. Method: blanch and make puree of spinach and coriander. Add ginger garlic paste and hunkard and lemon juice to it. Mix it well. Add salt and chaat masala to it. Now we talk about white marination. Ingredients are cashew nut paste 10 grams, onion paste 8 grams, cream 1 cup, white pepper 5 grams, salt to taste, oil according to taste, ginger paste 2 teaspoon, garlic paste 1 teaspoon. Method: make paste of cashew nut and onion, add oil to it, add ginger garlic paste and lemon juice to it. Mix it well, add cream and white pepper to it. Now we discuss about the recipe of tandoori chicken. Ingredients are chicken whole 2 number, Kashmiri red chili powder 3 teaspoon, lemon juice 4 teaspoon, salt to taste, yogurt 2 cup, ginger paste 1 teaspoon, garlic paste 1 teaspoon, garam masala powder 1 teaspoon. Method of making: give cuts or gashes with a knife on the chicken breast, legs and thighs. Mix 2 teaspoon Kashmiri red chili, 4 teaspoon lemon juice and with chicken, and put aside for absorption of ingredient for 1 hour. Then make a marinade by tying up yogurt in a muslin cloth and hang over a container for 30 minutes. Put the thick yogurt in a container, add the remaining Kashmiri red chili powder, salt, ginger, garlic paste and lemon juice, garam masala powder to it. Rub this marinade with chicken and marinate for 2 to 3 hours in a fridge. Truss the chicken onto a skewer and cook in a moderately hot temperature or in a preheated oven for 15 minutes or until almost done. Baste chicken with the oil or butter and cook for another 5 minutes. Take out and set aside. Now we talk about chicken haryali tikka. Ingredients: fresh coriander 20 grams, mint leaves 5 grams, fresh ginger 10 grams, garlic 10 grams, lemon juice 5 teaspoons, green chilies 2 numbers, salt to taste, chicken breast 250 grams. Method of making is, first of all, we have to make a puree of coriander, mint leaf, ginger, garlic, lemon juice, green chilies and salt. Mix all the ingredients along with the chicken. Refrigerate it 3 to 4 hours. Cook in a large kadai over medium heat till the inside become brown and outside is golden brown. Put it in tandoor. Put the chicken in the tandoor and heat for 30 minutes. Malai paneer tikka recipe ingredient. And the ingredients are cottage cheese 400 gram, cream 1 cup, yogurt 1 cup, garlic paste 1 teaspoon, ginger paste 1 teaspoon, green chilies finely chopped 1 to 2 numbers, lemon 3 teaspoon, coriander leaves 5 grams, red chili paste 2 teaspoon, cumin powder 2 teaspoon, salt accordingly. Method: add cream and curd in a container and mix them well with hand. Now take garlic, ginger, green chilies, red chili, roasted cumin powder and salt into the curd cream marination and mix it well. Curd cream marination and mix it well. Marinate fresh cottage cheese with this mixture. Keep it refrigerator for 5 to 6 hours. After 5 to 6 hours, take it out from refrigerator and slice the coriander and lemon juice. Put it in the tandoor for 15 minutes. Serve it with onion and lemon chunks. Tandoori gobi. Ingredients are cauliflower 2 numbers, hung curd 20 grams, turmeric powder 1/2 teaspoon, gram flour 2 teaspoon, yogurt 3 cups, kasuri methi 2 teaspoon, garlic paste 1 teaspoon, ginger paste 1 teaspoon, red chili powder 2 teaspoon, garam masala powder 1/2 teaspoon, lemon juice 5 teaspoon, salt to taste, carom seeds 1 teaspoon, mint leaves 1 teaspoon, coriander leaves finely chopped 5 teaspoon, green chili sliced 10 grams, mustard oil 3 teaspoon, chaat masala 2 teaspoon, butter for basting, and this is the method of making. Heat 4 cups of water with turmeric powder in a large hollow deep pan. When water starts boiling, add cauliflower in it. Boil it for 10 minutes, drain and put it under running water. Heat non-stick pan, add dry roast basin on medium fire till it gives out a nice odor or flavor. Put it into a container and keep aside. In a large container, mix hung curd, besan, kasuri methi, ginger paste, garlic paste, red chili powder, remaining turmeric powder, garam masala powder, lemon juice and salt. Mix it well and keep aside. In a container, mix together carom seeds, mint leaves, 1/2 of the cut coriander leaves, green chilies and salt. Heat the mustard oil and mix it in the mixture. And make a marination of the stuffed cauliflower in the yogurt mixture for 1 hour. Cook the cauliflower in the tandoor for 10 minutes. While cooking, baste the cauliflower with the oil. Take it out from the tandoor when done. Spread with chaat masala and serve hot. For tandoori roti, ingredients are whole wheat flour 250 grams, water 125 ml, ghee to taste. Method of making: knead the flour, spread the water and mix it well to form a non-sticky dough. Put that aside for 1 hour. Knead and take out 10 equal dumplings and press it with the hand to give them approximately 6 inch diameter. Take that flattened dough and place it on a gaddi and stick it to the walls of the hot tandoor. When it start browning and bulging out, remove the bread and pair of breadstick. With the pair of breadstick, sprinkle 1 teaspoon ghee and serve hot. For naan, we need white flour 250 grams or refined flour 250 grams, yogurt 1/2 cup, baking powder 1 teaspoon, yeast 1/2 teaspoon, egg 1 number, oil 1 tablespoon, salt 1 teaspoon, water as required. Method of making: knead the flour, mix the ingredient like yeast, baking powder and salt. Beat the egg and mix this into flour along with the oil and yogurt. Spread the water and sieve well to make smooth dumplings. Set aside for 4 hours. Make 10 equal dumplings. Press each dumpling for approximately 10 inch dia, put on the gaddi and moisten the side facing upward. Pull the dumplings from one side to give it a lengthened shape. Slap it on hot walls of hot tandoor. When it start browning and bulging out, remove the bread with pair of breadstick. Sprinkle 1 teaspoon ghee and serve hot. Now I would summarize The tandoor is an invention of great ancient times, a cooking equipment which either by accidentally or by human brain came to existence. In today's life, it's all around versatility. Make it most important for every restaurant. It is an equipment which still have the authenticity, besides a huge advancement in culinary world. Tandoor made of clay, aluminium and brick are best quality. In every restaurant, there is no menu which doesn't have any tandoori dish. In fact, there are special gourmet restaurants which serve a tandoori dish. It is saying that if somebody wants to know the person is good at making tandoor item, then he should check the hands of person, because there will definitely marks of burnt and no hair on his hands. This shows that being good requires a lot of hard work. Now, talking about equipments of tandoor, which is also unique, like gaddi, seekh, skewer. While installing new tandoor, spinach puree is applied so that it fills the patches of new tandoor and strengthen the walls of tandoor. Now, there are certain different marination which are the basic of tandoor dishes, that is red marination, yellow marination and white marination, green marination, white marination and green marination, which gives us dishes like tandoori chicken, Afghani chicken, Haryali chicken tikka, paneer tikka and cocktail kebab. So we hope that this all information will be helpful for everyone and gives benefit to the readers for working with tandoor and to experience new tasks in tandoor dishes. Thank you so much.